Hey guys, here I will show you how you can buy the mobile potato flag. By the way, what I didn't show was it drives very good at high speeds, and even by turning, doesn't flip over. And yeah, that drives really good. And now I will show you how you can buy it. The car here. So. For that we need a saddle, three electric engines, one gas engine, three buttons, one switch, one controller, four logic gates, four sensors, two off-road suspensions, four normal suspensions, two lights, some bearings. These pipe types, 5-way, straight, T-pipe and corner pipe, 4 wheels, 4 small chests, 1 fuel tank, 4 ammo, potato ammo boxes, and yeah, 4 potato cannons. So now we can begin. I will make first the frame for the wheels, and for that take a potato ammo box. Place it on the lift and one T-pipe here, and again potato ammo box, and if that doesn't work how you want, place it on the ground and use the valve tool and this corner to here. Now we must make a connection here at the bottom. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And the same on the other side. With the connection point to the front. If that doesn't work, again, place it on the ground and use the valve tool. So, and that must go here. So, T-pipe here, and again, the valve tool, and connecting it like so. Now we can attach the wheels. For that, jump here on top and place on the edges. Corner pipes and pointing down, take the normal suspensions and place them against the corner pipes, and again corner pipes, drive that and move it up so it's easier to make. So, bearings and the wheels. So now take the tests and place one here, and one here. One here. So now we can make the steering. Place on the connection point the bearing. Bearing the same on this side. Oh, sorry, no, don't do that here. Only on this side. Place corner pipe here. Take a long suspension here and so, this suspension glitch is for steering, and the other side gets a stabilization for the axis in this direction and for this axis, so it doesn't fall over, mostly. It helps a lot. So, for that we need to place one corner pipe here, bearing here, corner pipe, long suspension, a corner pipe, corner pipe, bearing, and corner pipe. Now weld the corner pipe to the armor box. So that is finished. So that is the bottom part of the potato flag. So now we can make the seat with the Gatling section, gun section. So for that we must extend the T-pipe two up and then the corner pipe. One, two. Same on the other side. One, two. Corner pipe. Corner pipe. Bearing and bearing. Now we must make a little cage out of the pipes for the seat. And yes, for that we need to. What I did take here. Ah, yes. We need this pipe here. That one. This can be placed like so. See? And here. Then take corner, straight pipe and go down once. And corner pipe here and here. Now take the fuel tank and place it against that pipe and drag it down like this. So now we can take the engine, the gas engine, place it against that and the controller here. Now we can direct wire the stabilization suspension glitch only to the controller, nothing more. That's all for that. Wire the engine to the fuel tank and now take the saddle and place the saddle on the fuel tank so that is covering the engine at the front. It's flush like so. Now you can place the electric engines, one here, one against that and one under that. That's all. Now we can close the cage here. Just connect for visual. You can make it. It's a bit, little bit for balance, but that is not much. So just so little frame around and here. That is not so important. Now we can make the front part. For that, take. Whoops, I'm stuck. T-pipe. Pointing up. Two. And forward. Then corner pipe. Corner pipe. And straight. Take the bearing. That's that, and now the five-way pipe, like so. Take the spud guns, potato cannons, and place them like this. Come on, let me place you. So, and one at the top. So, now take the sensors and oops, place them pointing back direct here. Come on. Oh, one too much. Ah. So and so. Then some logic gates. So. And we need one switch and one button. One switch and one button. Now take some lights. Place them against ammo crates. Connect them direct to the switch. That's all. And the button to all of the gates. And that's all. Okay. Must check that. And now you can connect the button to the seat and the switch to the seat. And now we have here basically a group of one sensor, one gate and one cannon. And if that spins this direction, then this sensor, this one, must activate this. If it spins this direction, then this one must activate this cannon. So keep that in mind, how you have that spinned around. I make that clockwise, so I will connect the bottom sensor to this, and this sensor to this, this to this, so on. Again, so sensor to the logic gate, and the logic gate to the smart gun. Same here. Logic gate to the sensor to the logic gate to the smart gun. It's hard to see, I know. So again, sensor, logic, logic, smart. Sensor, logic, logic, smart. Finish. So that is the fire mechanism. you must set the sensors on color mode and choose, for example, red for all color mode and red. And now you can take the color tool. And if it spins clockwise, then you can color, I think, that pipe and that pipe red. So it will activate that. But test this. Maybe you can make this and this one. So we will see that later. Now we can make the tilt mechanism. For that, wire this bearing to the first electric engine and this one to the second. The bottom electric engine to the spot gun bearing. And the button for the firing to the same electric engine that is spinning, and we need two more buttons, one here and one here. Connect each of them to one of the left electric engine, and I would say change the order of the buttons. First for tilt up, then for tilt down maybe, and then the fire button, and then the lights. So 1, 2, 3, 4. Now we can put some fuel in. A little bit ammo. Some batteries too. Whoops. Wrong button. Let me get some batteries. That thing used nearly nothing on batteries because the engine's mostly off. And here That was a little bit tricky to set that to the right speed. That is working for me, for the Gatling cannon. So let's try that out. Put some batteries in. So, and increase the suspensions. I think on 3 or 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. So, now we can wire the wheels to the gas engine. So we can drive. Change the direction and the light distance. I forgot. So, and now we jump in and nothing moves. Via the steering suspension bridge to the seat. And change the direction. And what is happening here? Oh, yeah, we must weld it. The cage sides must be joined together. So, that is one part. Forgot that. So, and now we can turn left and right. And here, stop. To connect that to the seat. The engine must be connected to the seat. Fuel must have from the tank, yes. Now we can drive back and forward. Just increase speed a little bit more. No, come on. Forward, forward, left, right, test the stability, yay, that is stable, and has suspension, perfect. Okay, now we can test the spinning of the Gatling. That is working, and we must change the color, left, right, back red. So it fires a little bit earlier, maybe that even too. Yeah, that is better. Now you can see the top gate gets on. And you can remove the color here, that is enough. So now connect each spot gun to one of the ammo boxes. So here. The engines have a little bit speed, so we can press the buttons for tilting. And I would say we are finished. And if the spin of the turning is too fast for you, you need to have the saddle on level 5. Then you can open up this and lower that a little bit down. Around 10 or 15, that is a good value. But that is how you want. So then you can kill farm bots, loot them. That thing has chests on it, and it's very good in driving, off-road ability, and mostly it doesn't fall over, so you can do it. Yeah. I hope you like that. If you like it, maybe give me a like. And what makes me more happier is a sub. That would be awesome. And see you soon with new ideas. And bye bye.